Hello students, so today I'm going to talk about the laparoscopic instruments and minimally invasive surgery is an important topic for your exam. A lot of questions are asked from it, from instruments and from various concepts regarding these instruments. Okay, so we'll start step by step how a laparoscopic surgery proceeds and it'll be easier for you to understand it that way. So the first thing in laparoscopy is that we have to achieve pneumoperitoneum, right? To achieve pneumoperitoneum, there are two methods. The most commonly used method is using a varies needle, right? Now this varies needle has been asked in the exam. Now you can see this varies needle. I want you to look at this varies needle closely. This varies needle, normally you can see that it is blunt or there is a beveled edge. But I want you to see what happens when we press it against a hard structure, right? Now I want you to observe carefully. So I want you to see that when I press it here, this gets retracted, right? So it's a spring-loaded instrument. It gets retracted when I press here. So when I press it against the abdominal wall, it is going to cut through. But once it cuts through, then the blunt tip again comes forward, right? So when it has to cut through, the blunt tip goes back, it cuts through, and then it comes back. So it prevents injury to the bowel. Now, once you've inserted a varies needle, how do we know that it's in the right position? So there are two methods. Method number one, put a drop of saline here. If you put a drop of saline and if it's in the peritoneal cavity, it will get sucked in. The saline is going to get sucked in. Okay. The other method is I'm going to inject saline. When you inject 10 cc of saline, it should freely go through, and then you should not be able to aspirate it back. That means it has gone into the peritoneal cavity. If we can't follow the Hassan's, if we can't do the varies needle method, then we do the open method or the Hassan's method. Okay. Now, once you've achieved pneumoperitoneum, then we have to put in a trocar. Okay, so this is a laparoscopic trocar. You can see here that this is a metallic trocar. This is the trocar. This is the sheath through which instruments will go in. So once you put in the trocar, after that you can introduce instruments through it. Now just in case, while putting the trocar, if there is a bowel injury, then what you need to do is you need to immediately convert to an open surgery, but we keep the trocar in position. Keep the trocar in position so that you can localize the site of injury. So that was a 10 millimeter trocar. These are smaller trocars. You can have 5 millimeter, 3 millimeter trocars as well. Now, once you've introduced a trocar, then you put in laparoscopic instruments through them. Okay, and laparoscopic instruments are long black instruments. And you can see that only the tip is exposed, right? Only the tip is exposed. Now, the reason why these are black is that they're coated with insulation. And the need for coating them with insulation is that when I attach the cautery here, then I want the cautery to act only at the tip. Yeah, I want it to act only at the tip. I don't want current to leak out from the entire instrument. Right? That is why they are coated with insulation. If the insulation breaks off, then current can leak out. And I want you to understand this principle. This is the instrument which is going in through this trocar. Now, if the insulation is broken, current will leak out. It is going to go into this metallic trocar, and the metallic trocar is in contact with the skin, so it's going to burn the abdominal wall. This principle is called capacitance. It has been asked in the exam. Right? So how do we prevent capacitance? We prevent capacitance by maintaining proper insulation or by using a completely plastic trocar. So those are the two ways how we can prevent capacitance from occurring. Now, I'll tell you about the laparoscopic instrument. So you can look here. This is like your forceps, which we use normally. This is called a Maryland's tissue dissector, a Maryland's dissector. This is the workhorse of a laparoscopic instrument, of a laparoscopic surgeon. This is the most commonly used instrument by a laparoscopic surgeon. The other instruments you can see here, look at this one. This one, if you look carefully at this instrument, this is in the shape of a dolphin's mouth. So this is the dolphin instrument, okay? You can have similarly a crocodile. This is in the shape of a crocodile's mouth. So a crocodile grasper. This is a crocodile grasper. You can have laparoscopic scissors. These are laparoscopic scissors which are there. Again, only the tip is exposed. These are clip applicators to ligate the cystic artery, cystic duct. We use clips. This is a clip applicator. Okay. This is a hook used for dissecting the gallbladder of the gallbladder bed. And this is a suction, a laparoscopic suction apparatus. Now, normally in conventional laparoscopy, we put in multiple trocars. Multiple trocars are inserted. There are modifications. There is one modification known as SILS,